What's the very first thing that comes to your mind when you hear the word connection? Let's see right now. Close your eyes. And what do you picture when you hear me say connection? Open your eyes again. And if the first thought you had is related to phone, computer, technology, the internet, raise your hand. If what you first thought of is related to friends, family, people, relationships in your life, raise your hand. Isn't it fascinating that the exact same word, connection, can both be related to scrolling Instagram on your phone and being intimate with your partner? Maybe you didn't raise your hand because for you, connection first meant sustainability or creativity. Our whole world is based on connection, from connecting people to connecting ideas. Today, we're taking connection to a whole new level. I'm Katie Studdart, the host for today, and connection is what I live for. As a coach, I'm passionate about connecting people to what matters most in their life and in their work. It is an honor to be here with you today, here in the center of Gothenburg, and through the maritime industry, connection is at the very heart of Gothenburg, as it is the largest port in the Nordic countries. Curiosity brought you here, and emotion will keep you here. Be prepared to laugh, to cry, to be moved, and to connect with each other and all of the amazing speakers. Ladies and gentlemen, a very warm welcome to TEDx Gothenburg. And a very big thank you to all of our partners, ECARX, Göteborg and Co., Nudie Jeans and AV1. The event will be divided in three parts. There'll be 10 amazing speakers, several musical acts, and in between each part, there'll be a 45-minute break, and you can use the opportunity to connect and also to use the restrooms and the cafeteria that are right outside behind you. As the event is being filmed live, please remember to keep your phone switched off. If a phone rings, the speaker will have to repeat the last few minutes of their speech. So once more, please remember to keep your phone off. Enough of the practicalities, let's get started. In life, there are three taboos: money, sex, and death. Today, each of these topics will be covered. In TEDx, there are no taboos. We start off the evening with the first topic of money. How can you make your money work for you? Our next speaker is an independent economist, author, and lecturer. He worked as a journalist and in the last decades as a public economist for Avanza Bank. He's well known for his talk shows on economy in sports arenas and for supporting families in the Swedish television series, Låna för livet, Borrow for Life. Please welcome to the stage, Claes Hemberg. What an amazing day this has been. I can still feel the energy buzzing in the room. You came here with the curiosity to learn more, to discover, to look at connection under all its angles. Hopefully, you've taken away some tools, some ideas, some concepts to support you to connect on a deeper level. A great TEDx event is one where you leave with more questions than you had when you first arrived, where more doors have been opened in your mind. What conversations are you going to start? Which one will you have tomorrow? Will you dare to tackle the topics of money, sex, and death?
Or will you discuss sustainability, looking at greenwashing or the food industry? Perhaps you'll talk about place identity or transparency in democracy. You'll start to ask great questions and maybe seek to create value in innovative ways. The day does not end here. You're all invited to join us on the Scandic Rubinen rooftop bar to take the conversation further. It will be an opportunity for you to meet the speakers, the TEDx organizers, and it would be wonderful to see you all there. It has been a joy and a privilege to be your host today. And in the words of the author, E.M. Forster, only connect. Thank you very much. Okay. In today's world, we're constantly connected. Most of the time, though, this is through technology. How do you feel that technology has supported you to connect with others? How can you optimize your use of technology? Our next speaker is a professor of software engineering at Chalmers University and Lappeenranta University in Finland. She's one of the founders of the Sustainability Design Initiative that aims to advance the research on sustainability in IT. She coined the term software engineering for sustainability. And in the past 3 years, she has integrated her education as a yoga teacher and as an embodied mindfulness coach to focus on the well-being and resilience of people and society. Please welcome to the stage Birgit Penzenstadler. Can you get people interested in climate through dance? Yet, this is what our next act does on a regular basis. These are some of the best dancers in all of Sweden. They're part of the dance company Twisted Feet, and they have a funded project, Passion for Climate. Today, they will perform an extract of their show, 5 Degrees. Without further ado, please give them a big round of applause. Most of you are probably interested in living in a healthy way, perhaps even lowering your carbon footprint. Maybe you sort out your waste, or you try to fly less. But how about when you're in a supermarket? This is where our next speaker comes in. He's the founder and CEO of Carbon Cloud, and through combining a business mind and a scientific understanding of climate change and food production, his mission is to change the way the global food industry thinks about food and climate. Please show a very warm welcome to David Bringelson. How quickly time flies. We've already reached the time where it's a break. You have a 45-minute break, and you can use the opportunity to connect and talk with the speakers, to meet each other, and also to use the restrooms and the cafeteria that are behind. So I'm looking forward to seeing you all in 45 minutes, and please be here a few minutes before. Welcome back. As a reminder, before we continue, we've been doing great with the phones. So once more, please make sure your phone is switched off for the last part of today. Hope you're feeling energized and focused. And maybe during the break, you discussed the news. Yet, you might wonder, how can you trust the news? Our next speaker should know. He's a reporter for Swedish television, and he was nominated for the Gold Spade in 2014. Most people know him for his reporting in the United States during the elections in 2020. Please show a very warm welcome to Fuad Yousefi. What is greenwashing and how do you know if a company is using greenwashing or not? In a world constantly more sustainability focused, these are the types of questions that come up. The following speaker is a journalist, a consultant, and a published author with a focus on sustainability. She's the co-founder of the non-profit organization Climate Club. Please welcome to the stage Maria Soxbo. Now we will continue with today's speaker. What are the little things in everyday life that make a relationship work? Our next speaker has more than one string to his bow. He's an educator, a social worker, a therapist, and a sexologist. Many of you will be familiar with him as he is the sexologist on Married at First Sight, where people hope to find true love by being matched with the perfect partner. But is it really that easy to get things going in a relationship? Let's find out. Please welcome to the stage, Khalid Norwald.